Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I'm going to share with you this potent green juice recipe. I know it's red, but it is a green juice recipe. And the reason I'm preparing you with these recipes is because the beginning of the year is coming, and I know a lot of you are going to be reaching out to me asking me what juices can you take for the new year, and this is a good juice for you to add to your repertoire. So if you want to see how I make this juice, stay tuned. The first ingredient is burdock root. It is a blood purifier. Then here comes the hot pepper. I'm using jalapenos. I would have used a whole one, but I didn't have one available at that time. But you can use other peppers as well, or if the pepper is too much, you can just leave it out. Next is the lime, which has the vitamin C, which helps pull the iron out of the food to absorb into your system. Then we've got ginger and turmeric, and then we've got these two beets. Did you ever notice or ever hear the expression that beets look like ovaries? There's English cucumbers. I prefer English cucumbers because they are bigger than normal cucumbers. Then I had a small head of romaine or red leaf lettuce in my refrigerator that I wanted to get rid of. It just adds a lot of water to the juice. Then there's celery, which is mineral rich, and then there's the dill weed. You should always add some type of herb to your juice. It just packs a punch. Today I'm using my Nama J2 juicer. You all know that I prefer the Green Star, but if I'm trying to make things fast, the Nama is great. So I'm adding as much as I can to the hopper so that I can get this juiced. The best thing you want to do with a juicer is buy the one you can afford and buy the one that you're going to use. Whether it's a Nama or a Green Star or some other type of juicer, just be sure that it's going to be the one that you can use for your own particular healing journey. But I do recommend, do not buy cheap juicers because you will waste money by wasting produce. So I just wanted to share that with you. It's a beautiful day out today as I'm making my juice. So throw all the rest of your ingredients in your juicer and juice until your heart's content. And then once you're done with your juice, I strain my juice. Once I'm done juicing, I strain my juice. And I pour my juice into glass mason jars. It's important that you use glass because when you put these juices in plastic, it leaches the plastic. So you want to go to the dollar store, to Walmart, and buy yourself some glass containers so that you can be safe with your juice. And I pour my juice into the mason jars. If I'm not going to drink them that day, what I'll try to do is fill it all the way to the top of the mason jar so I can have as little air in it as possible. You can also vacuum seal your jars, which I don't have a vacuum sealer. I'm thinking about getting one. But the key is that you drink your juice within 3 days. After that, it pretty much loses all its nutrients. It's not bad, but this batch juicing that they're talking about, keeping juice for a week, is not doing the same thing that 1 to 3 day old juice is doing for you. So anyway, I hate to pop people's bubble with that, but that's the truth. Anyway, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Comment below. Don't forget to look down in the description box for resources that can help you on your healing journey. And if no one told you that they love you today, Chelsea in North Carolina loves you very much. And I'll talk to you soon. Take care.